Welcome everybody to my channel, Movement by MaryAnngeline. My name is MaryAnngeline, and this channel is dedicated to the intermediate, advanced yogis, but of course everyone is welcome. So if you are practicing at a different level, just be sure to modify where you need to. I won't integrate any props, but if you'd like to add that to your practice, just place them by your mat. And today's intention is gonna be all about dancer's pose. Maybe some awkward fun variations and just really working those quadriceps, really stretching through quadriceps today. All right, so let's get started in child's pose. Come onto your shins, extend your arms in front of you, forehead presses down on the mat. You can choose to have your arms by your sides or under your forehead if that feels better. As you settle in, close your eyes. Begin to heighten your awareness of the breath. Heighten your awareness of the body. And heighten your awareness of the connection between the two, the body and the breath. We'll be here for just a few more cycles of breath. On your next inhale, shift forward to tabletop. All your weight comes into your hands. Bend your right knee, squeeze your right heel to your bottom, and resend it back to child's pose. Inhale, tabletop. This time, left heel to left bottom. Squeeze it in. Exhale, child's pose. Inhale, shift forward, tabletop, right heel to the bottom. Hold it this time. Tuck your left toes, lift your left knee. Pause. Bend the elbows, bring the chin and the chest down to the mat. Keep squeezing that right heel in as tightly as you can. And then slither your way forward to a low cobra. Toes point, tops of the feet tap down, inner thighs hug in. Press into the palms, initiate from your tailbone, and send your way back to child's pose. Second side, let's shift forward into the hands, tabletop, left heel to the bottom, squeeze in. Tuck the right toes, lift the right knee off the ground. Lower chin, chest down to the mat. Keep squeezing that left heel in. Slither forward, low cobra. Straighten the leg, point the toes, press down through tops of feet. Initiating from the tailbone, send it back. Child's pose. Tabletop, here we go. Shift forward, right heel to the booty. Tuck the left toes, lift the left knee. Lift the right knee. Continue to hug that right heel into the booty. Bring your right knee to nose, round the spine, curl it in. Three-legged dog, send that right leg high. Take a moment to flex and point through the right foot. Maybe add some circles. And take that right leg even higher, bend the knee, scorpion. Feel a nice stretch to the right hip flexor. Maybe even into the outer hip a bit. Restraighten that right leg. Lower the right shin down to the ground. Shift forward. Think of plank pose with right shin down. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, take your left leg across to the right. So we're coming into a little bit of a twist. You can ground down through that foot and take your gaze towards your left heel. You should feel this stretch through left ribs, left side body. Return back to where we started. Left leg plants down. Left shin taps down, booty to heels, child's pose.
Second side, let's come into our tabletop.
Squeeze your left heel to your bottom. Tuck the right toes, lift the right knee. Lift the left knee now and continue to squeeze that heel to the bottom. Draw the belly in, round the spine, knee to nose. Curl. Three-legged dog, send the left leg high. Add some movement into the left foot. Point flex, circles.
whatever feels good. Take the left leg a little higher, bend the knee, scorpion. Stretch through the hip. And as you stretch the hip, keep the integrity of the shoulders and your right leg. Let's re-straighten that left leg. Bring your left shin down to the ground. Keep the right leg as it is. The right leg now moves across the mat to the left. So you're taking a little twist. Gaze moves towards that right leg, which is now on the left side edge of your mat. Breathe into the right side body. Come back to where we started, right leg right behind you. Right shin to the ground, booty to heels, child's pose.
Take a deep breath in through the nose. Deep breath out. This time let's shift forward to table and squeeze both heels to the bottom. Bend both elbows, chin, chest down to the mat. Slither forward, upward facing dog. Straighten the arms, point the toes, hug the inner thighs, let the shoulders roll back. Proud through the chest. Drop the knees down, child's pose, booty to heels.
Tabletop, shift forward. Bend the knees, heels to bottom. Now lift the chest like you would for up dog as you squeeze the heels towards your bottom. Continue to hug them in, continue to open heart. Lower the feet to the ground, tuck the toes under. Downward facing dog, pelvis up, chest back. Gaze adjusts between maybe the toes, maybe you look at your knees, but keep the legs nice and strong and active. We'll be in this down dog for just a couple more cycles of breath, adding any movement that you may need. On your next in-breath, extend the right leg back and up and bend the knee, scorpion. Keep the knee bent, bring the knee to the left elbow across the body, tap the elbow. Send it back up to that scorpion. Feeling some stretch in the hip. And again, across the body to the left, knee taps, elbow. One more time, send it up and back. And across the body. This time we send it up and back and hold it. Steady your weight into your right hand and your left foot. And start to slowly slide the left fingertips back. You can keep the hand on the mat and turn the fingers towards the back of the mat, reaching them as far back as you can. You can hold here or take the left hand to the right foot and hold onto the foot. Press the foot into the hand, pull the foot closer to the booty. Release the left hand back to neutral, so in line with your right, and step your right foot between your palms. Rise up, crescent lunge, back leg stays nice and straight, front knee is bent, both arms reach tall. Take one more deep breath in, maybe turn the gaze up. As you exhale, hands to heart center, tap the left knee down to the ground. Twist to the right, hook the elbow, little prayer twist, roll right shoulder back. The left hand will stay where it is. Lift up the left foot, point the toes, reach the right hand behind you and grab a hold of that foot. So we do a little half prayer with our hand and a quadricep stretch with the right hand on the left leg. Continue to hold on to that foot, release the left hand down to the ground on the inside of the right foot. Then press the hips deeper and hold here. You can roll the chest open. You can turn the gaze up, but continue to press the foot into the hand. You'll get a deeper stretch. Steady breath.
As you start to unwind, so pull the hip bones back first, then rotate the back leg, which is your left leg, out to the right. We're gonna take a seat. So as you rotate the leg down, lower the booty to the mat. Your left leg should be under your right and continue to fold over the right leg.
Feel the compression of the right leg on top of the left ankle. Continue to breathe fully and deeply. And begin to unwind the body.
You can use your hands if you'd like, but we're gonna shift our weight forward into the right foot, hand to the top of the mat, left leg goes high, little standing split, forehead towards the shin. Active and strong through the left leg, through the quadriceps, and through the glutes.
Take one more deep breath in. As you exhale, squeeze the left heel to the bottom. Take the right hand to grab that foot. Now tap down, left knee to right ankle, bend both knees. Then slowly bring it back up. Knee can go a little bit higher. Two more times. So left knee drops down to right ankle. And as you straighten it out, send the left knee up towards the skies. One more time. Knee to ankle, tap down. And lift it up. Now rotate your right hand onto the pinky side of your lifted leg, your left leg. Halfway lift the spine, draw the belly in, kick the foot into the hand, bring your left hand to your hip and make your way up into awkward dancer. If that was too intense, you can always release the posture and just meet us up standing when you're ready. Left arm can go up towards sky or left arm towards front of your space. Breathe deeply. And we're gonna mimic what we did on the ground in our tabletop with a twist, if you will. So gently release the back leg, straighten it out, move through a warrior three, flex the left foot, bend your right knee, and take your left leg to the outer edge of your right side of your mat. Take your gaze towards that foot. Hands come down to the ground. We return back into our standing split. Left leg goes high. You should really feel your right leg turned on by now. Bring your left heel to the bottom, knee to nose. Strong through that right straight leg. Round your spine all the way up to one-legged mountain. Left knee pulls through, arms reach high. Take one more inhale, lift a little taller. Exhale, crescent lunge where we started. Deep breath in. Exhale, plant palms, step the right foot back, lower through chaturanga. On your inhale, upward facing. And exhale, downward facing. Pause in this down dog. Where is your breath? Where are your thoughts? Where's your gaze? Come back to center, come back to present. And let's continue on, second side. Left leg goes high, nice straight leg. Bend the knee, scorpion. Keep the knee bent, we'll bring the knee around across the body to the right elbow. Give it a little tap. Send it back and up, open up through hip. Again, knee to elbow, across to the right. Tap, and send it up. Last one here, knee to elbow. Tap, and send it up. Now hold your scorpion. Engage your right leg, put all your weight into your right foot and your left hand. Release some weight out of the right hand and start to slide the fingers back. Turn the fingers towards the back edge of your mat. You can stay here or take your hand to your left foot. Kick the foot into the hand. Make sure there's equal weight between your hand and your foot that's grounding down. And breathe. Let's release back. Right hand meets left. Left leg straightens out and step the left foot between the palms. Rise up, crescent lunge. Both arms reach high. Maybe turn the gaze up. And take one more inhale. Exhale, hands to heart, tap the right knee down. Keep the toes tucked under for now. Twist towards your left, hook the elbow. Little prayer twist. Roll the left shoulder back. Take the gaze back. Now keep your prayer twist, but we're gonna stay half. Start to squeeze your right heel to your bottom. You can point the toes. Left hand goes to that foot. You pull it in. As you continue to rotate the chest, open. Continue to work this stretch. We're just gonna deepen it. So start to bring your right hand to the inside of your left foot. Press your hips towards the mat as you press your foot away from you. And then continue to grow the heart up and out as you turn your gaze up towards the ceiling. Begin to unwind your torso. As you pull your hips back, pivot your right foot towards the left side of your mat. Start to bring your shin down and lower your booty all the way to the ground. Let yourself fold over your left leg. Our left leg is on top of our right, so we're compressing the right shin down towards the ground. Couple more cycles of breath here. Begin to round up the spine. You can use your hands on the ground or not. We're gonna shift our weight forward into our left leg, plant the hands at the top of the mat, lift the right leg, we're in our standing split. Head drops down, forehead towards shin. Right leg goes high, nice, strong, straight leg. Bend the knee, squeeze the heel to the bottom, grab a hold of the foot with the left hand. Now tap right knee to left ankle, bend the knees, tap down. And as you straighten the left leg, rotate the right knee up, you'll get a deeper stretch. Think of like fallen soldier here. Two more times. Knee to ankle. And unwind, send it up. One more time, knee to ankle. And send it up. So staying here, all we're gonna do is adjust the left hand on the right foot. So you're gonna bring it to the pinky side of the foot. And kick into that hand. Lift the heart halfway. Draw the belly in. Start to make your way up to awkward dancer pose. Again, you can release the posture and just come straight up. It is a pretty challenging transition. That left leg's working very hard right now. And once you get there, find a space for your arm and find one point of focus, excuse me. Our release is into a warrior three. Right leg straightens, arms reach forward. Flex the right foot and then sweep that leg to the left side of your mat as you bend your left knee. Take your gaze towards your right foot to the left. Hands touch down, come back to your standing split. Lift that leg up. Take a breath in. Exhale, heel to the booty. Knees together. Start to round up, one-legged mountain. Knee pulls through, arms reach high, gaze goes forward. Send the right leg back, crescent lunge, turn the gaze up, plant the hands, step your right, left foot to your right, plank, chaturanga, upward facing
and downward facing. Pause in your down dog. Reconnect. Take one more inhale. One more exhale. On your next inhale, right leg goes high. Bend the knee, scorpion. Flip our scorpion, come into wild thing, plant the foot, reach the right arm. Circle that right hand behind you, start to transition to your side plank, but grab a hold of the right ankle. So think of this as a dancer in side plank. Take one more inhale. As you exhale, release your right hand down like plank pose. Step your right foot between your palms. Rise up, crescent lunge. Reach arms up. Airplane pose, now we sweep the arms back, shift the weight forward. Bend the left knee, grab a hold of the foot, inner or outer, and rise yourself up to dancer's pose. Traditional dancers. This time we're gonna hold onto the foot. Think the same transition like we did on the ground, hand lifted with that lunge twist. So as you bend your right knee, bring your left knee towards the right side of your mat. Grab a hold of your foot and hold. So both hands are on my back foot. I'm mimicking that straight leg, but now my knee is bent. I'm gonna switch hands, keep my right hand there. Left hand reaches forward. Hold. And then drop all the way down. I give myself a hug. I'm in a twist. Look towards the back edge of the mat. Begin to unwind the body. Plant the hands at the top of the mat. Send the left leg high, standing split. One last time. Crescent lunge. Reach it up. Plant the hands, vinyasa, wash it out. Any variation you'd like. Second side, left leg goes high. Bend the knee, scorpion, flip your dog wide and right into wild thing. Transition to your side plank. As you do, circle the left hand behind you, grab a hold of the left foot, kick the foot back and away. Take one more inhale. Exhale, left hand to the mat. Left foot steps forward between your palms. Rise up, crescent lunge. Airplane pose, shift the weight. Here we go. Arms sweep back. Right leg extends. Bend the right knee. Grab a hold of that right foot, dancer's pose. Left arm goes high. Heart goes up. Right leg kicks back. All right, here we go. Start to lean forward a bit. Sweep your left hand behind you. Adjust your hands so you're grabbing a hold of your foot with both hands. Bend your knees. Bring your right knee to your left. Switch the hands, so left hand's on the foot. Right arm reaches forward and you're twisting that right leg to the left side. And we're slowly lowering it down. Booty to the ground, taking your twist. Right hand around that left leg. Look to the left. That was a little sloppy for me on that side. And it's a good thing to remember that both sides will feel very different. So meet each of them exactly where you're at. Let's slowly begin to unwind to the top of the mat. Both hands plant. Right leg shoots up, standing split. Head drops down. And crescent lunge. Both arms go high. One more round of vinyasa. We'll meet in down dog. Once in down dog, you can step, hop, jump, handstand, float your way forward to forward fold and then to seated. So no fancy way of getting there unless you want to take it really fancy, which is fine.
Let's meet on our backs, lying down. Reach the arms overhead, straighten your legs out for long body stretch. Hug the right knee into the chest, give it a nice squeeze. And as you bring your right knee in, straighten your left out, leg out a little longer. Let's take an easy twist. Knee falls to the left, gaze to the right. Bring it back to center, hug the right knee in. Switch it out, left leg hugs in, right leg straightens. We'll pause here for a moment. Draw the knee across the body to the right as you switch your gaze to the left. Bring it back to center. As you come back onto your back body, pull your right knee in to meet your left. Give them a tight squeeze. And then round up forehead to your knees. Reach your hands behind your feet and pull yourself very tight. Really release it out. Run into our final pose, Shavasana. These classes go by very quickly with being only 30 minutes, so we'll take a very short Shavasana. So please rest here. We'll be here in silence for a very short amount of time. But when it is time, I will guide us out. So just be and enjoy. Begin to slowly awaken the body. Breathe in movement back in. And allow this movement to gradually bring you up to seated. Once you make your way seated, close your eyes. Bring your palms to touch. Rub the hands together. Place the warmth of the left hand on your heart, right hand on top of your left. Bow your chin to your chest, representing the love, gratitude, and compassion you have for yourself. I want to thank you for joining me. I wish you well. Until next time, namaste. Alrighty, thank you everyone for being on your mat today with me. If you have any questions or comments, just put them in the box below. If you have any requests on a specific type of video, please let me know. And if you want more, I do have a virtual studio. It's a membership-based platform, and there's about 200 videos on there, all different types of styles of yoga, and I have classes from 5 minutes to 75 minutes with some great other great teachers also. So if you are interested, check the box below. There's the link there. And I hope to see you all again soon. Thank you.